Good morning.
So, in this class, I would like to explain about the shape memory alloys. A shape memory alloy is the material that remembers its shape and can be made to return to its initial shape after being deformed if subjected to an appropriate thermal process. Here, thermal process means it is heating or cooling process. So, example for the shape memory alloys: nickel, titanium, copper, aluminium, nickel, etc. In shape memory alloy, also called as smart material or intelligence materials. Next one, the types of the shape memory alloys. There are two types of shape memory alloys are possible. One is called one-way shape memory alloy. Second one is two-way shape memory alloys. One-way shape memory alloy, it exhibits the shape memory effect on heating only. Suppose you apply the cooling effect, the phase transition is not possible. Another one is a two-way shape memory alloy. It exhibits a shape memory effect on both heating and cooling. So first of all, it will have some shape. So you apply the heating effect, it is converted into another one. After the change in the phase, you apply the cooling effect, it is returned back to its original shape. So heating and the cooling both are changed the phase. So this is called as two-way shape memory alloys. The phases in shape memory alloys. Shape memory alloy have two stable phases. One is called austenite and another one is called martensite. Austenite is the high temperature phase. It have body centered cubic structures. Another one is a martensite. It has low temperature phase. It have phase centered cubic system. In this diagram, this is the temperature scale. This is the low temperature and this is the higher temperature. At lower temperature, the shape memory alloy exhibits the martensite phases. And higher temperature, it exhibits the austenite phases. This is the micro and macro structure of shape memory phases. This is austenite. This is the higher temperature body-centered cubic system. This is the twinned martensite low temperature phase. It have phase-centered cubic system. In this case, austenite and twinned martensite both have the same size of the materials. Its macro state is not changed, but micro structure is deviate from the austenite. So another one is the deformed martensite. It is completely changed in the macro shape because the twinned martensite under the stress, it is converted into deformed martensite. It is not changed depend the temperature value. So these are the macro structure and these are the micro structures. Next one is the temperature induced transformation. The phase transformation takes place in a shape memory alloys over a range of temperature. It is not occurs at a particular temperature. It is the over range. This is called the temperature induced transformation. We'll take it now. The temperature along the x component, x axis. Along the y-axis, in the left-hand side, I take it now the fraction of martensite and right-hand side is the fraction of austenite. Already we know about the martensite. Martensite is the low temperature phase. So you take it now the low temperature, this is higher temperature range. At low temperature range, it is exhibits the martensite. It is continue up to a certain limit. Suppose I increase the temperature value, it is changed to the martensite. So the martensite is changed to the austenite between these two points. After this point, it is exhibits the complete austenite materials. So this point is called at now austenite starting point and this is the austenite final point. Between these two points, the part of the material have the martensite and remaining part of the material exhibits the austenite properties. Suppose I cooling effect is increased, I apply the cooling effect, so the austenite is continue up to a certain limit. After this point, it is changed to the martensite. So this is the cooling effect. So this point is molten-8 starting point, and this is the molten-8 final point. Between these two points, the both stable states or exhibits, or both phases are exhibits. So some material exhibits the austenite phase, and some material or exhibits the molten-8 phases. So this is the complete graphical representation for the temperature induced transformation of austenite and molten-8. So this point is the pure austenite material. So the molten-8 fraction equal to 0. This is complete molten-8 material. So its value equal to 1, fraction value equal to 1. The right hand side here, this is the complete molten-8. So austenite ratio equal to 0, fraction equal to 0. This is the complete austenite. So the austenite fraction equal to 1. So next one is the shape memory effect. The recovery of strains imparted to the material at low temperature as a result of heating is called the shape memory effect. This line is represent the temperature value, and this line represented the load value. This is the lower temperature and this is the higher temperature value. Already we know the high temperature materials or austenite, and lower temperature materials is the faces the molten-8. This is called twinned molten-8. So the austenite material is involved in the cooling process. It is its phase transformed to molten-8, twinned molten-8. So after change the twinned molten-8, you apply the heating effect, it is converted into its original shape or austenite shape. So this is the two-way shape memory effect. Suppose the twinned molten-8 is under the stress or any under the load value, it is changed to deformed twinned molten-8. This is a deformed shape. So this transformation occurs only depend on the load or stress value. The deformed twinned molten-8 material involved in the heating process, it is returned back to the austenite shape or austenite materials. So this is the one-way process. So without the any load, you apply the cooling effect, the austenite material is not gained, it twinned, deformed twinned molten-8 shape. So this is the one-way shape memory effect. Pseudo-elasticity. The formation of stress-induced molten-8 from austenite phase result in a phenomena called pseudo-elasticity. In this case, this is the temperature line, this is the load line. In general, higher temperature is austenite phase, lower temperature is the molten-8 phase. But here, the deformed twinned molten-8 phase occurs at a higher temperature range. So this deformation occurs only depend on the stress value. At higher temperature, the austenite material under the stress value, it is converted into deformed twinned molten-8. Suppose if you remove the stress value or load value, it is regained its initial austenite shape. This transformation occurs at a higher temperature. So due to the stress or load value, without the temperature change, the deformation is called as pseudo-elasticity. Nickel titanium alloy or nitinol. The nitinol stands for Nickel Titanium Novel Ordnance Laboratory. The nickel alloys exhibits two closely related and unique properties. One is shape memory effect and another one is pseudo-elastic effect. The shape memory effect is completely dependent on the temperature value, and the pseudo-elastic effect is completely dependent on the load or stress value. It is temperature induced process. This one is the stress or load induced process. It exhibits the enormous elasticity, nearly 10 to 30 times that of the ordinary materials. Nickel titanium alloy or nitinol properties. It have high melting point around 1300 degrees Celsius. The transformation temperature ranges 200 to 110 degrees Celsius. The density of nickel titanium alloy is 6450 kg per meter cube. It have high thermal stability and corrosion resistance. The thermal resistivity is 100 milliohm for the austenite phase and 70 milliohm for the molten-8 phase. Its yield strength is 195 to 690 megapascal for austenite phase, 70 to 145 megapascal for the martensite phase. Application of shape memory alloys. The shape memory alloy used as the tantal arch wire. This is the tantal arch wire. It will make the misaligned teeth gradually to original shape. So next one is the SMA used as the blood clot filter and also the stent in the coronary artery block. So this is the cholesterol is occupied inside the coronary artery. So the blood flow is disturbed. So the SMA stent is fixed at this position. So you apply the stress or thermal process, it is expanded. So the blood disturbance is completely clear. So blood is freely flow in this artery. Next one, the first consumer commercial application was of shape memory coupling or pipings. Example, oil line pipes and water pipes. So you will take it now, this is the small size of the pipe. So this is the coupling material, its radius is bigger. So it is cover these two joining per tube. Then you apply the heat energy or thermal process. So it is tightly bind with the tube. So it is act as the best coupling for these two connecting tubes. So this is the automatic thermal valve. So this is the heat liquid flow in this tube. It is allow for a certain time. After reach the certain temperature value or the higher value, automatically the SMA spring is compressed. So this valve is closed. So hot water is not, hot liquid is not moving this type, this way. So this is closed. The cold water is moving this way. So this is act as the automatic thermal valve. This is the example for the shape memory alloy spring. So it is used in the automatic springs. So here we apply the stress value, it get the deformed positions. So apply after the heat energy, it is gain heat initial shape. So this is the example for the shape memory materials. Merits and demerits of shape memory alloys. Merits: biocompatibility, diverse field of application. So it is used in the different field, automobile field, medical field, engineering field. So it is used in the different ways. Good mechanical properties, strong and corrosion resistance. Demerits are expensive material, so it is a very costly material. Ferropatic properties. So ferropatic means you apply the stress value very often, maybe it will be broken. So low energy efficiency. If you have any query, please mail to sanmadi@gmail.com or sunphysics17@gmail.com. Thank you.